guys, welcome back to the Results Show, where we feature real health coaches and health practitioners getting real health results for their clients and themselves. As always, I'm your host, Brent Burmeier. I'm a clinical advisor for FDN, as well as I'm the director of our tribe's awesome association, where we support the community with ongoing education regarding a variety of clinical and business building topics. This week, I'm super stoked to have my friend Justine on the show. So Justine actually completed the course, the FDN course, back in 2016 and has been successfully practicing FDN ever since. So welcome to the show, Justine.
Thank you. I'm excited to be here, really.
Yeah, I'm excited to have you here. And I love this Real Results Show. I love getting to have these just organic, fun, educational, inspiring conversations with very like-minded professionals. We all kind of find our way to FDN, and those paths are always very similar. So I'd love to kind of kickstart the conversation to hear in your own words, you know, what prompted you to become an FDN and pursue this career path?
Okay. Yeah. So long history short, I ended up being diagnosed with fibromyalgia and had to leave the military because I was no longer deployable, right? Mm-hmm. And I was a senior NCO. I was being evaluated for E8, and that's pretty high rank. And yet I had to leave because my body froze up. I had palsy really bad. And so I did a whole lot of stuff on my own. And one of the things I did, I'm like a consummate learner. So I have multiple degrees and everything. But when it came down to taking care of me, because doctors were just putting me on pills and the VA wanted to put me on disability, I went out looking for my own answers. And I started off with exercise, which wasn't bad, but it could have been easier. And basically, I ended up in health coaching school because nutrition, getting a degree in nutrition or something like that, there wasn't a lot of food science and stuff. And I'd already taken a lot of biology and so forth, but just didn't seem the right fit. And so I became a health coach, really, for me, got me off of all my medication. It got me really feeling good. I haven't had anything until kidney stones, nothing since 2013. And I was stoned 24 hours a day before that. And so health coaching was great. But when I decided to leave my job and do this full time, health coaching really wasn't enough. Mm-hmm. I'm a bit of a science geek. And the other thing was, is I was working with women at the time with fibromyalgia. I've kind of migrated into another area. I still support them, but from a different angle. But I needed something a little bit more. And FDN actually really was perfect for that because I needed to get into the science of stuff because without it, I really couldn't do what I needed to get done. And in my own case, I was exhausted. My cortisol sum was like 9. I really, really needed some help myself. And so during the course, of course, I took care of myself. I took the test and I did all the different steps. And now my labs are great. You know, everything across the board, cholesterol, all that stuff is really great. But having that FDN, you know, education behind me and you guys behind me, I can actually help people quickly and not, I wouldn't say completely, but, you know, really quickly and in real terms. As a health coach, for instance, I was just talking to you about Melissa. I'll use one of my clients. She came to me with menopause issues and her hormone therapy wasn't working. And if I was a health coach, I would have maybe come up with detoxification as an issue and some other things. And I would have coached her through that. But with FDN and doing some lab work, we actually came up with some surprising results. But what happened was, is we found out that there was very key nutrients that she was missing. And within just a couple of weeks of supplements, I was able to just turn her whole life around. But also it gave me the evidence to have a real heart-to-heart talk with her about her diet, because she had been a vegan most of her life. And even though she had added some fish into her diet, it really wasn't enough. And it turns out she's a fast oxidizer. So she really needs a lot of high purine foods in her diet. And with that evidence, I was really able to help her, you know, make some adjustments, still maintain being a vegan for the most part, but adding some animal products into her diet in a very thoughtful way. And, you know, now she has hot flashes, but no more sweating. She wakes up a little bit at night still, but she can go back to sleep and she can sleep in. She doesn't feel anxious during the day and just frazzled all the time. So all of these things really, really changed for her. And as a health coach, I may have gotten her there, but it would have been 6 months, you know, something like that. And it may never have gotten it all the way. So I'm really thrilled to be able to have this training and support and everything to help me really make a quicker and more of a difference, I think.
Mm-hmm. Well, and you're exactly right. We're happy to have you as part of the community. I think I'm just stupid passionate about the whole movement that our community is leading the charge on. I really feel like FDN practitioners are kind of the tip of the spear when it comes to the chronic disease epidemic, because look, I mean, there's a time for drugs and surgery. Absolutely. Hands down. Yeah. That's kind of the ultimate safety net. And hey, we need a lot of health coaches too. But there's this huge needs gap in between allopathic kind of emergency care versus generic health coaching. You know, it's never made sense to me to try to coach somebody towards better health without objective data about how their body works. It's never made sense.
Yeah. I mean, if you're working with a doctor or somebody and they have, you know, access to some of the stuff that we do, and really you're coaching them towards, you know, making those changes or coaching them towards making their own changes, that's one thing. And I really think health coaches have a very important role. Oh, it's just for me, it wasn't enough because of my background and really what I want to do with people. And, you know, again, on the flip side, I'm really glad I'm not a naturopathic doctor or have done some other things, because I have the ability to do the coaching aspect. I really have gone into a lot of neuroscience coaching. I work with a guy out of the UK, mind mapping. And basically between those two, I can just do some really incredible work. And my practice isn't huge, but it's not huge because that's not what I want. I really want to be really intimate with my clients and really work deep work with them. And, you know, that's what I get to do. And so it's exactly, you know, my practice and I are set up exactly the way I want my life to be. And so FDN helps me do that. I couldn't do it if I was more in the, you know, physician side of the house, and I couldn't do it as a coach, but as an FDN practitioner, I'm right in the right space for me.
Yeah, I love hearing that. I really do, because, you know, I can relate to that 100%. Mm-hmm. And you're exactly right, where we have the objective data with the lab testing to guide our recommendations, and we use a holistic lifestyle model, you know, diet, rest, exercise, stress reduction, supplementation. You know, and a lot of times, like, we really are filling that gap, because otherwise, you know, the typical client, like with us, they might kind of have an all-in-one, you know, coach, practitioner, all-in-one, whereas otherwise, yeah, maybe you're working with a naturopath that's chasing whatever thing that naturopath is into, and then they've got a health coach telling them they need to go keto, even though they have no idea if that's true or not. Right. So the FDN methodology really kind of cuts through a lot of that. And there's a reason I'm sitting here tonight. I've never seen another, you know, educational body that puts it all together, the holistic lifestyle based coaching with the clinical objective laboratory data. So yeah. I'd love to hear how, I love everything you're saying. I'd love to hear how going through the FDN course and working on your own health, which is obviously a part of the course, helped you, you know, take back your health a little bit. You alluded to it there.
Yeah. So the reason why I quit my profession, so I still stayed working after the military. I was working for the United States Army and I was a software developer and working with developing a pretty big application. Think Infusionsoft and a little bit bigger, handling languages from all over the world, not the major languages, right? Because it's for the military. So pretty big deal. But I had some family crisis. I lost both my mothers in the space of 6 months. I'd already lost my stepfather. And my father is, you know, he's healthy, but he's not healthy, right? And he was really depressed afterwards, of course. And I had to deal with all the estates and stuff. And so when I went back to work, you know, my vertigo was kind of back and I told you my adrenal, my cortisol sum was a 9. I really wasn't feeling well. And I just felt like all the work I was doing had been slipping back and life needs to be better than this. Both of my mothers had suffered with hormone issues and weight issues and emotional issues. And one had thyroid cancer and all these different things. And all they were doing was medicating. There was nothing for them. Now, my mother, once she was diagnosed with cancer, because I was a health coach, she and I worked together and she actually outlived what they estimated by quite a lot. And she did really, really well. And I think she was a success story, even though she did pass away from it. But it's still, again, it should have been different. And so when I went back to work, I just didn't feel like being there anymore. And so that's why I quit. And then I'd been looking at FDN for quite a while, but because I was working full time and I was just health coaching on the side, people I knew, I didn't sign up, but then I did because I said, okay, I'm going to do this and this is what I want to do. So I signed up and I was excited about taking the test for me because I knew I wasn't feeling well. And so through the course of taking the course and getting back into all the biology and chemistry stuff that I really always enjoyed, because before the military I was going to vet school. So joined the military to pay for vet school and then I ended up loving it. So I stayed. But so it just helped me get all myself back, right? It just gave me the foundation. And one of the things I wanted to say about FDN, which is really, really cool. And I believe this before FDN, but it really helps me work with clients, is that it's nonspecific. So as a health coach, everybody is going, okay, you have to niche. And I do niche to a point, you know, I do that. And the reason is because I feel very strongly about my message and stuff, but I don't have to. And before FDN, it was really anti giving me a diagnosis. Like, it's just, okay, I have fibromyalgia, so I have vertigo. So I can't do anything about the vertigo because I have fibromyalgia. Well, that's BS. Basically, you have to figure out, well, what causes vertigo and what causes digestive problems? And yes, my hypothalamus pituitary gland, you know, they're not working all that great, but there are things I can do. Not just because I have cancer or fibromyalgia or whatever the diagnosis is. So looking at symptoms very differently. And FDN really helps you do that because it's like, we don't diagnose, we don't treat the test results. We're about looking for, you know, I love the way Reed puts it, hidden, you know, opportunities for healing and looking for all those patterns of dysfunction, because that's actually what works. That is actually what people need to do. And when, you know, having a diagnosis is helpful to a point, but if you identify with it, you're stuck. And FDN allows me to get people beyond that. And that's really great.
I really like how you worded that of, you know, the diagnosis, it can be helpful at times, but then if they start identifying, right, they start telling themselves that story of this disease happened to me. I am a victim. There's nothing I can do. I'm powerless. I have to rely on the guy in the white coat to treat me and cure me. And this is something I get really fired up about. I very firmly believe nobody can heal you but you. And doctor is a Latin word that means to teach. So I truly believe the greatest medicine of all is to teach people how not to need it. And that's exactly what FDN practitioners are really doing at the end of the day. And as you said, we don't chase symptoms. We do a very, very thorough intake, but we don't chase symptoms. We don't treat the lab results. And I was just recording a podcast earlier and we were talking about that with there's a lot of practitioners out there, both conventional and functional, that kind of take a shotgun approach of, well, let's run 10 tests and start throwing supplements and or medications at the test results, at the test paper. And FDN, we're all about the clinical critical thinking skills coupled with the health coaching client-centered model to really guide them in the right direction. There's no pill that's going to overpower your environment and your lifestyle, you know?
No, no, absolutely not. And you know, I told you, I work with the neuroscience end of coaching quite a bit. And so in my practice, I'm always talking about environments. And environments are your internal physical environment, to your internal dialogue, to your hygiene, your projected self, to your clothes, your family, everything. And your sensory system, what it's doing is it's scanning your environments all the time. And your brain is determining whether you're safe or not based on the patterns that the sensory system is picking up. Mm-hmm. And it leads that way. And so by working with people that way and avoiding this whole idea of I'm a victim or even a survivor, being a survivor is almost as bad as being a victim of what you have, because you're still giving your power up to whatever that diagnosis is. It's great to a point to get you like on your feet, but after that, you got to become the leader in your, in your life. And so by understanding your environments and really being aware, I, as the FDN practitioner, have experience and resources and strategies and all these different things, but I'm not your accountability partner. I'm not the person who's telling you what to do. I'm the person who's saying, how are you feeling? What's going on? Is this working for you? Is this not working? You know, I lead them down a path, but at the same time, they're in charge. And it changes everything, because it's not just their health that changes, it's their whole attitude about what is possible for them and what they can do. And I think that that is, you know, for me, that's like, that's the whole bit. And you said something about, you know, doctors being guides and they're really responsible. What I do is I teach based on a philosophy of, you know, your reality of health, happiness and success is designed by you, but it's not built by you alone. And so we still need to lean on people and resources and stuff, but it's still yours, right? You are the responsible person. And then there's some principles that they can follow to help that. So, but you know, the dress protocol is under there. I call it a dress because I use awareness and then I use desires. Your subconscious is the D, and then the dress aspect. So
I really like that.
All there together. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I really like that. Address. Mm.
And I use that word all the time, right? You have to address this and you have to address that. And that means bringing all those pieces together. So it works really, really well.
Absolutely. It's kind of the ultimate health building model. And you said it earlier as far as you know, kind of picking a particular demographic or niche and all of that. Mm-hmm. And I think what's really cool and nice about the FDN methodology is literally any type of professional that is a health service provider, could be psychology, mm-hmm. massage therapy, acupuncture, doesn't matter.
Right.
It's a methodology that you can add to your professional skill set. And even though we all go through the same initial basic training, what you do with that mm-hmm. is highly individualized. And so like with you, you're combining it with some of the more, you know, neuro-based coaching strategies and the mind mapping, or somebody else might use it as a part of their physical therapy practice. So I think it's really cool how like you can pick very particular demographics, because there's no shortage of sick people. Unfortunately, that's really a horrible thing.
Yeah.
But, you know, there's no shortage of them. So then it's like you can pick what kind of demographic. But also, I really like it, too, because I'm a huge advocate of, you know, our health is really the combination of our psychology and physiology. It's like a yin yang. I just yeah. posted about this the other day. You can't heal one without healing the other. You have to be
Absolutely.
Addressing both. And that's what I hear you doing, is you're addressing the brain game, the psycho-emotional, combined with that more physiological health building protocol with the FDN. And,
yeah.
you know, you're obviously doing some amazing work as a result of that.
Well, that's, you know, if you remember with fibromyalgia, when I got diagnosed, so I had symptoms in the 90s, but I didn't get diagnosed with it until 2001 officially. And immediately my GP doctor made the comment, well, it's all in your head. It was like one minute he cared about me, the next minute he dismissed me. And at the time, I was like devastated. And in the VA, when you have sleep issues and stuff, you have to see a psychiatrist. And she marched down there and said, get out of her head. You take care of her. She's not insane. And so she fired my doctor for me. But now I laugh because I said, of course it's in your head, for two reasons. A lot of the research is pointing towards the hypothalamus, and guess where that's at? And number two, everything that goes on in your head affects your physiology, and everything that's going on physiologically is affecting you emotionally and mentally.
Exactly.
You cannot separate them. They go together hand in hand. And so now when somebody says that, I say, yeah, you're absolutely right. And, you know, and then I carry on with why, but of course it's like, I own it, you know, mm-hmm. and I absolutely am like, you're not going to trip me up with that one.
Right.
So yeah, that's my background in that. What I do though is I do support women and men with fibromyalgia, but I don't do it directly. One of the things I realized as a practitioner was that it's just too big, and you're up against an army of doctors, and a lot of people are fighting for people to believe that they're sick. And so if they get well a little bit and then they relapse, you know, people aren't going to believe them anymore. So it's really a really tough condition to tackle with them head on. And so I started really moving into the hormone realm, because hormones, if you have an emotional or a physical condition, your stress response system is going to be activated and your hormone balance is going to go out of whack, period. Of course, gut health, all of those things tie in, but that stress response system is, you know, number one, and it's kind of key in my book. It's not the thing that's dysfunctional, and we were talking about that. Hormones aren't the problem. I'm really into the big hormone lie right now, because everybody thinks menopause is all about imbalanced hormones. But if your hormone therapy is not working, it's not hormones. It's something deeper than that. We have to go in and figure out, because they're just responding to mixed signals from dysfunction and different things like that. So by coming in from the hormone direction, now I can tackle things for fibromyalgia, because they separate imbalanced hormones and fibromyalgia, right? But I'm still doing exactly the same thing I would do with them anyway. Mm-hmm. So it's just a little safer for them to say, oh, well, I'm in menopause. You know, I have fibromyalgia, but I'm also in menopause, but you can help me with the balancing my hormones, right? So I can help them both ways. But anyway, it's mine. That's
fantastic. Yeah. So do you work with clients in person or virtually or a little bit of both?
Only virtually. I mean, I have a woman in a nearby town where we could talk, and I have done it in person in the past, but I only work virtually just because of convenience. I travel a lot. I told you I have one father left. I have to be able to pick up and go and see him at any moment in time. Plus, I'm just an avid traveler. I do a little bit of consulting now in the UK, and I have family over there, so I hop over there a bit. And so I need to be mobile. And so virtually is how I work. I do plan on doing location retreats based on my philosophy and stuff like that in the future. But right now I just do 3-day virtual retreats with them.
I think that's really cool. I love the virtual life, a lot of freedom, flexibility, unlimited. You can work with people around the world.
Yeah. And I've had clients be worried about it, you know, initially, right? Because it's something different. But then once they get used to it and they recognize just how much more contact they have with me, the way I've structured my business is they have a lot of access to me. And that's why I want it to be small, because I want to be really intimate with my clients. And so once they realize that, they're just like, whoa, this is way better than going to the doctor's office, driving through traffic and all that stuff. So it works well.
That's awesome. Yeah, I think you're doing amazing work, and hearing your story, it's just, as always, inspiring, and obviously you're perfect fit. You know, that's the cool thing. Us FDNs, we are really a tight-knit community, kind of tight-knit family, very like-minded people. But as we start wrapping up the show, Justine, where can people learn more about you or get in touch with you?
Well, they can go to if you know Justine Cecile, that's my work name, justinececile.com, Justine Cecile on Instagram, Facebook, Justine Cecile Coaching. I also have a women's group on Facebook. It's kind of small. I'm pulling them through challenges, you know, as much as I can, called Designing Oneself. And so I do have that group as well. But if you just remember Justine Cecile, you'll find me. Nobody else has that name anywhere. So
perfect. So. Good name. I like it. Well, very good. Yeah. Go ahead.
I was just going to say, I finally have a platform where I can use my first and middle name.
Yeah. Middle name. Cecile is your middle name.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm just going to share a little something about me, because I think it's really cool. Yeah. So I'm about to turn 55 on the 14th of July. And if you know what that day is, it's Bastille Day in France. This is the French Revolution. And my name, Justine Cecile, means heavenly justice in French, not modern French, but French. And I've always thought that was really cool. So, and
I think that's really cool.
This weekend. So,
hey, Justine, guess what?
What?
We have the same birthday.
Do we?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
How cool.
July 14th, Bastille Day.
Yeah.
I don't have any cool story behind.
What's really awesome, I've always talked about going to Tahiti on my birthday, but on my 25th birthday, I was stationed in Germany, and I went to Paris for the 200th anniversary of the storming of the Bastille. That's got to be like the best birthday ever. So.
That's really cool. I'm going to be flying home. I'll be on a plane, but you know,
I will be too.
I'm gonna go eat some tacos, though. That's what I'm gonna do.
I'm heading up to Vancouver to visit my dad on the 14th. So I'll be up there, and then we'll eat French food.
Yeah, I love it. Well, you know, thanks so much for being a guest on the show, Justine. And before we wrap up, I do have a special announcement that I want to tell everybody about. We have a really cool event coming up, the Ultimate Health Coaching Summit, which is being hosted by FDN's very own fearless leader and captain, and really a true health coaching pioneer, Reed Davis. So the summit actually includes over 36 expert speakers talking about all things related to being a successful health coach and creating a successful business doing it. You can get all the details and your free access pass to the summit at fdn.today/coachsummit. And I think we already put that into the comment box for those watching if you want to be able to go access that. But an amazing summit. There's going to be just a wealth of information. So if you are a health coach, if you're an aspiring health coach, or you're somebody struggling with your health, looking for education or a coach, definitely the place to be. So again, fdn.today/coachsummit. And then, of course, for those of you that are ready to become a true health detective so you can help others on a deeper level like we talk about every week in this show, you can schedule a call with an FDN course counselor at functionaldiagnosticnutrition.com/counselor. Or if you're ready to enroll and take that plunge into a beautiful world, you can go to functionaldiagnosticnutrition.com/Facebook Live. We do have those again in the comments here. And of course, we'll have all those links posted. But just wanted to announce that. And again, be sure to check out Justine Cecile on social media, the website, all the above, if you resonate with her and want to get in touch with her. So. Justine, thank you again, my friend.
Thank you.
We share a birthday. I mean, that I feel like we're energetically connected now.
You know? That's very cool. Yeah, that's very, very cool. So
awesome.
Cancers all the way.
Yeah, I know. Mercury retrograde has been rough on this Cancer, but you know, we'll get through it. But
we'll be fine. Yeah.
Yeah, absolute privilege. So thanks again. And I'm sure I'll catch you in the AFDNP group and maybe we'll have another call sometime soon.
All right. I'd love it. Okay. Take care.
Perfect. Thank you.
Bye, everybody.
See you guys next week.